Hey everybody, Tyrant here with the First Virtual Fighter Wing. This is the introductory video for LSOBot, which is a carrier landing grading tool that I wrote along with a lot of help from Team LSOBot to include Flounder, Shady, and the rest of the gang at the First Virtual Fighter Wing, and especially the 401st, our Hornet Squadron. Before we can show you how to use this tool, we need to go ahead and record some ACMI, so let's head into BMS and record a trap. Okay, so here we are on approach at about a mile and a half here, and you can see from the green light here that I have my ACMI on. The first thing that I'm going to do is to turn ACMI, unpause it, turn ACMI off and then back on again. Now the reason that I do that is because I want to keep the part of the ACMI that LSOBot is going to look at as small as possible. LSO will start detecting traps at around 1 mile from the boat, so you want to make sure that you, by the time you're on approach, maybe when you're on your base leg or whatever you squids call it, I'm not a Hornet pilot, you would flip your ACMI off if it's on and then turn it back on again. Regardless, you want to make sure your ACMI is on, since LSOBot does look at ACMI data. So now that I have my ACMI toggled on again during my approach, I'm gonna go ahead and attempt the trap. And like I said, I'm a Viper pilot, so this probably won't be too pretty, but I can usually get it on the deck. Famous last words here, but let's go ahead. Okay. All right, our next step is to load up the ACMI in TACView. So TACView is a really great tool if you're not familiar with it. It is required to use LSOBot. Really excellent tool, though. Highly recommend that you make it part of your tool suite. I will point out that I am using this on my Mac under Wine. The tool, when run under Windows, as it usually would be, looks way better. Virtuoz has done a good job with this, but it's easier for me to do this on my Mac, so that's what I'm doing here. So I'm going to go ahead and open up that VHS file that we just recorded, the ACMI file that we recorded from the flight, the trap we just did. So there it is. I'll say open it. And then I don't need to do anything in here. I could go ahead and look at it. I'm not going to do that, though. The only reason we need to open it up is so that we can then save it as... And we're going to save it as, doesn't matter the name, what we want to do is make sure that we save it as a .txt.acmi file. So you can see you got a bunch of options here. We want the TACView text telemetry data. And so the newer versions of TACView do have a .zip.acmi format. You want to make sure that you save this as the .txt.acmi file. So go ahead and save that, and then we are done in TACView. Now that we have recorded the trap in ACMI and converted it to .txt.acmi format with TACView, we can go ahead and load up LSOBot. So LSOBot is simply a web page. There's nothing to install. You go to the URL candera.github.io/LSOBot in your favorite browser. At a release here, we're supporting Chrome, Firefox, Internet Explorer, and Safari. They should all work. Other browsers may work as well. And the first step, of course, is to load an ACMI. So we're going to click the Load ACMI button, and then I'm going to load up that ACMI file that I converted with TACView. So let's see, I had that guy here. Where is it? Here we go. My TACView ACMI. And I know you can't see the open button there, but it's there. All right, and so once we do that, it'll run analysis on it, and depending on how big the file is, how many traps there are, it may take a little while. This is a pretty small file, and so it's going to show up fairly quickly. And what you're seeing here is a few things. So at the top, we have a grading sheet for all the traps. Now this particular file has only one trap. We'll switch in a minute to a file that has more than one so you can see how that works. But here we have a row for the one trap that's here. It has a grade, which is C for cut. It was a very, very bad pass, and so I got a cut pass, a score of 0. I shouldn't have tried to land that one. It was pretty terrible. And then the score 0 is just a numerical reflection of that grade. Then we have columns for all the way, AW, X for start, IM for in the middle, IC for in close, and AR for at the ramp. And those are the sections, the phases of the trap. You can see them reflected here. Here's the start, in the middle, in close, and at the ramp, delineated by these vertical lines. At the moment, power and ATT are not implemented, so you'll never see anything in these columns. That will be coming in a future version of LSOBot at some point. And then finally, we have the lineup and wing column here, which shows how we did sort of left to right. Now, the symbology here, I'm not going to go through it all. It's explained pretty well in the help, which are these little blue circles with a question mark. There's a fair amount of information here that you can read through. It should be pretty self-evident. If you do have questions about it, this information was taken from the NADOPS manual, so I'll refer you to that as well for some of the symbology. Very briefly, you will see things like F for fast, H for high. The parentheses mean a little bit, and the underline means a lot. So in this case, all the way I was fast, and we'll get into how you would read that from this graph in a minute. And at the start, I was a little high, which you can see here. The yellow dots indicate that I was above the ideal glide slope of 3.3 degrees. Similarly, for the lineup and wing, a little bit left at the start, a little bit left in the middle, left in close, and at the ramp, very far left. So that information, that same information that's presented here as a sort of grade. Oh, and then of course there's the wire, right? Like in this case, LSOBot estimates that we hit the 2 wire, which, if you remember the video from the trap, is a pretty reasonable guess. You know, somewhere in there. So that's an estimate, but we think it's a pretty good one. Falcon does not actually contain information to tell us exactly which wire we hit. So this is our best guess. We did a lot of work here, and we think that this is a pretty good estimate. Certainly welcome feedback on that if you have cases that you think don't line up with that. So then what else we're seeing here is the glide slope and AOA window, and again, there's help for that that describes what you're seeing there. But briefly, this is just a overhead and then an overhead and a side view of your approach. And the large dots indicate just that. The large dots here indicate where you were vertically. You know, here we were pretty much on the glide slope. As I came in here, I was high, and then got good, and then kind of got low towards the end. And the colors indicate severity. So green is ideal, yellow is you were off a bit, there's an orange, which is you were off a bit more, and then a red, which is you were way off. And so the large dots, like I said, indicate your glide slope, and then and the bottom view indicate your lineup, how far left or right you were. I was pretty far left throughout this approach, definitely was not in the ideal zone of 1 degree left or right from directly lined up. Then the other thing that you see here, this might be a little bit hard to see, so I'll increase the zoom here, is these smaller dots which correspond to the larger dots. So there's, for every one of these large dots, you'll see a smaller dot above or below it. And that's indicating your angle of attack. So in this case, the position of the dot indicates what, relative to the large dot, the position of the small dot relative to the large dot indicates what your AOA was relative to ideal. In this case, because this dot is considerably below the corresponding large dot, it means that my AOA was fairly low. Lower even than it was here, where it was low, but not as low as it was here. Now, AOA is effectively your speed, and so a low AOA means I was fast, and that, in fact, is reflected in the grading sheet. We see that all the way we were fast, and in fact, yes, my AOA was below the glide slope dots the entire way, indicating that I was fast the entire way. So, if we had a perfect approach, these AOA dots would be exactly on the glide slope dots. That would mean that your AOA was not deviated at all from ideal. Hopefully that makes sense. We find this to be pretty easy to read. Hopefully you will too. I want to show you what a multipass looks like. So let me go ahead and load up another ACMI file here. So it's going to be in my LSOBot, projects LSOBot. ACMI, I have a bunch in here. So let's show you some by some people that actually are Hornet pilots, virtual Hornet pilots in the 401st, in the 1st VFW. So let's see, I could take a look at, say, this one. So now this is a larger file, and so you'll see that the larger the file is, it does take longer. It was pretty much instantaneous when there's one pass, but this file has quite a few passes in it, so we click load, and we're going to get a little spinner and the message that says loading until it manages to chunk through all of the data in that .txt.acmi file, and then eventually it will give us information about the passes in that file. So here we can see that we've got quite a few passes by Flounder, Shady, and Rocket 41, 42, 43, and 44. That's here in the pilot column. So Rocket, that's AI. We'll look at those in a minute. One thing I want to point out to you is that you can sort. So the darkened triangle here indicates that we are sorting primarily by carrier. Now, of course, there's only one carrier here, but we can sort by pilot. That didn't change, but if we click it again, it will sort by reverse pilot. We could, of course, also sort by time or by reverse time. The default is to sort first by carrier, then by pilot, then by time, so which is a pretty reasonable default. But you can see that there were a variety of different things going on here in the various passes, and we can look at whichever ones we want. Let's look at this pass. So that's Shady. He got an OK, which is a very good grade. And as you can kind of see from looking at this pass, it's a pretty good pass. Like, he came in pretty much right on. His AOA, let's zoom in, was... the small dots are close to the big dots, meaning his AOA was close to ideal, and he didn't have too many big deviations, so he got a grade of OK. Now, when you have a lot of passes like this, it can be a little bit cluttered and hard to flip back and forth. And so there's this button here, Only Show Selected Pass. If I click that, it'll narrow it down, so we're only seeing the one pass. We can go back to showing all passes, pick a different pass. Maybe here's one by Flounder. Only show that one, and here we go. And he got a grade of B, which means he bolted for whatever reason. The hook didn't catch the wire, and he went ahead and went around and landed again. That's really it. I mean, it really is this visualization of glide slope, AOA, which is basically your speed, and your lineup. And the colors show you how well you did. I guess there's one thing I forgot to show you, which is, let's look at, say, a... let's look at Shady's really good pass there again. And if we look in here, there's something that's kind of subtle, but I want to point it out to you, which is the green circles mean you had a good, in this case, it's glide slope, good glide slope. And then some of them have this white border around the edge. That means ideal. That means that he was exactly on. And you might be looking at this and saying, well, it looks like he was actually a little bit low, but LSOBot does take into consideration that the landing area is not zero size, and so you can be ideally lined up or on ideal glide slope. And there's a bit of a tolerance there because you're aimed at 3.3 degrees for some part of the touchdown area. So that's what that white circle, that white border means, is that you were ideal. You were ideally lined up or ideally on glide slope. One more thing to mention, which is... you can export this data as CSV. So here we have, I don't know, whatever that is, a couple dozen passes maybe. We can click export as CSV. It'll prompt us to download. We can save that, and now we have a CSV that we can load into our Greeny board or Excel or whatever other tooling you would like to use. And it's just all this data from the grading sheet. So it'll just, you know, it'll have a column like carrier, pilot, time, grade, score, and so forth and so on. That really covers the basics. Definitely encourage you to ask questions, give feedback on the forum, which is kind of the official page for this, support page for this, and there'll be a link right here. It's not active right now because we haven't launched yet as I record this. But if you click there, it'll take you over to the LSOBot page on the BMS forums. Also would encourage you to come by firstfighterwing.com, visit the first virtual fighter wing. If you want to learn how to land on a carrier, Flounder, Shady, Drillin, and the rest of the crew would be happy to bring you on. Check out our recruiting page, join up, and enjoy carrier ops with a bunch of great guys. That's all for now. Thanks.